But it's not if you are physical in here, it's not if you are physical financially.
The problem is that the IPAT, you just analyze it. We are not specific that the financially, you just analyze.
But then on the content, you have missed a lot of important information to present. And your content is fine, but your explanation somehow is different from what's in the content. Okay. So
and as you heard with me, somebody, the one who was supposed to be our group neighbor, changed his name to me because he has a really bad extra to his house. So he was trying to be some really great.
I just have to revise on community. So there are procedures, there are steps before, or to say there are steps of these approaches. One is the participatory development or community participation. We're talking of participatory development, PD. It seeks to engage the local people in development projects. So you need to engage these local people in development projects. Why? Because we talked of the grassroots process. They are the owners of the communities. They know better than the one doing in the project. So we need to let them participate. As they are participating in this development project, it's one way of developing their project, their communities. Why? As a project, you're not going to be there forever. The community members are going to be there. They are going to manage or to proceed or to continue with the project that you introduced to them. So you need to involve them. Starting from the planning stage up to the evaluation stage, they have to know whatever is happening in the project. That's why I also mentioned using locally available resources, so that whenever maybe there's a damage somewhere, they should be able to be there. It should be sustainable. So there are benefits of community participation. One of the benefits is that it binds together social, religion, and traditional law. So as we're working with these community members, remember they are from different religions, they are from different cultures. You may be working with one community, but members of that community, they're coming from different backgrounds. So as they're working together, it helps to bind them together. They share their religion and beliefs, even their tradition. It also helps to achieve better decision making. So remember to say that it should start with them. So from the planning stage. So as they're planning, it helps you reach a certain agreement stage, whereby you're making decisions, you reach a certain agreement stage. So it helps to achieve a better decision making, whereby each and every member will agree to whatever decision you make. And it also involves people to work together. For them to work together, it increases democracy. It helps in empowering people. It also helps in resource mobilization. In resource mobilization, we are talking of the available resources in the community. It can be in terms of skills. So they mobilize all the resources that are there in the community to support the principles. There are types of community participation. One of the types that is passive participation. Under this passive participation, people participate by being told what is going to happen or what has already happened through a gradual announcement by administration. So this is passive participation. You tell the community members what is going to happen or what has already happened. You announce to them, we are going to do this, we are going to do this, so that one of the participation. Another participation is participation in information giving. So this is more like the, when you're using questionnaires and surveys. You ask questions, they give you feedback. That's another way of letting commission members participate in the project. We also have participation by consultation. You go into the community, you consult the community members, maybe so that they should give you their views or ideas on solving problems. So that's participation. There is participation for material incentives, whereby you ask the community members to provide resources. For example, you can ask for labor, food, cash from the community members. Whenever you're doing community development activities, it should be aided to 20 participation. 80% should come from the organization, 20% should come from the community. So that participation for material incentives, you ask something from the community members, they feel that they are participating in their development activity. There is self-mobilization. Sometimes people, they do choose to involve themselves to do a certain project without being asked. So that's self-mobilization. And the functional participation, people participate by forming groups to meet a certain objective. So you form groups in the community. In those groups, you have objectives. So you participate using these groups in order to achieve the objectives that you have. So these are some of the types of community participation. Community participation, you try as much as possible to involve the community members in developmental activity. It should not be compulsory. I'm going to now, let's say, participate. Commercial sometimes you may not involve all the community members. You select important people that you feel like you can involve them in the community. You may not also part of community participation because they are members of the community and you have involved them. That's community participation. Do you have questions?
To improve the whole
whole thing of people.
To bring peace and harmony.
How do you develop community?
By using the approaches.
And why do you want to develop community?
To improve the community.
Thank you.
Without involving these key members, it would be very hard for you to mobilize people. Kumano mbaka kuna BGC ya kumu ndani, ama chwa kwa ina ana kwa jete, kwa uzaji kwa li project hii, ama ina kuna kwa kino kwa jete, it should be go around the organization. Remember we discussed about philosophy of community development. So what is the philosophy of community development?
Yeah.
Someone is away.
Can you
take one?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.